Yes?
I'm sorry for disturbing you on an important day like this, but... have you, by any chance, seen Jack since yesterday?
Has something happened?
He's gone. We've been looking for him all morning.
Well, we love him.
No, I haven't seen him. Does anyone know why he left?
Well, yes. And I'm afraid it is my fault. I had him locked away. But in the end, I just punished anger with wrath.
Well, find him then.
My monks are already trawling the woods. I myself will go to Shirin, while Martha is taking a horse to a cave he used to know. Please, don't let this spoil the first day of your marriage, when there should be only reason to rejoice.
Thank you.
Bah. Reason to rejoice, a marriage with this man 3 days later. There's no way I'd be able to marry this man.
How long has it been?
3 days.
Well, I think he's gone for good. I love him like a brother. But first, he tries to kill me. Then he runs off, worrying and his family's sick.
Are you hungry? I think I'll prepare some food.
Great. I'm starving.
Oh, I thought he attacked Tom, not Alfred. Man, you're a jerk, Alfred. No, I won't brood about him. Not today. Make first pottage for your husband. I find it hard to focus these days, but little by little I am making progress. Soon it will be finished. I don't feel like going out. There's not much outside anyway. I bought them with my own coin when I still had an income. Don't care if I use them up now. Well... bedroom. I'm glad he never touched me. Hey, you and me both, girl. Probably don't even know what to do anyway. Martha brought them over yesterday, the day before. Time passes so fast. Let's go ahead and grab eggs.
We've been married for what? A week?
I haven't been counting.
Right. Feels like a lifetime already, doesn't it? Yet, we still haven't... you know...
Oh, I'm sorry. I want this to work, but I need time.
Is it all right? Sometimes you look at me like you think your husband isn't a good man. But I am a good man. You'll see.
I mean, yeah, maybe, but... not right now, Alfred. What else do we have? What's down here? What is that thing? Is it like a window into the basement? Alright, let's grab some spices. Is he still just waiting for us to cook something and we just keep grabbing like spices and eggs? I have to cook again. Soon I need more spices.
You need any help?
You could prepare the meat.
How do I do that?
Oh, never mind. I've got it.
Useless. Cooking pot. I already soaked the wheat and added the milk. So are we making some type of bread? Oh my goodness. This is taking forever to make whatever
Today,
she's
I was
making.
I'm thinking about what you and Philip did for our workers when they were afraid that they wouldn't be paid. Offering them coin to make them stay and feel safe. What if I did something similar? How about I could offer them pay in case something happens? Like an insurance? What do you think?
Could you afford it?
That's up to the prior to decide. He said he'd come over around noon tomorrow. Maybe he could eat with us. And you could help me explain the idea, if you want. I think it would be good for you to do something other than cooking and weaving. You haven't left the house in 2 weeks.
17 days, but who's counting?
You're right. I'd be glad to help.
Ah, great.
Cook again. The cooking pot.
It still needs eggs.
Takes like a month to cook one meal.
Would you like venison with it?
No, thank you. I am just here to talk.
Ascetic as always, I see.
It just turns more and more into a habit, really.
So glad he is alive because Ellen forced the monk in black to lie, and because Jack caught the monk, Jack. So glad he is alive. Okay, Philip. He's looking paler than usual and thinner. Even the novices started whispering about him. What else do we have? That's all I need. It's ready to cook. Alfred moved into the other room. He argued, I snore too much. I won't brood about him. Oy, oy, oy. I wonder what Jack is doing.
So, you are suggesting that we promise the workers money if the construction is not completed?
Yes. As an insurance. Since the fleece fair, they've been quite worried. It would ease their minds a bit.
Yes. Especially since they'd know they don't have to finish the cathedral in order to get rich. It sounds to me like we would be tempting them to fail deliberately.
I hadn't thought about that.
I'm not gonna say anything. This is Philip, or I'm sorry, this is Alfred's thing.
Of course.
Thing.
You have a point. I just think it would be a good idea. It would ease the workers' minds a bit.
Yes, you said that. Your idea shows great compassion, Alfred.
Thank you, Father.
Maybe a year ago, I would have been convinced. But nowadays, I find it hard to believe in the virtuousness of man. Still, it would not have made a difference anyway. I could never promise them coin, because one cannot give what one does not have. Ever since the market collapsed, Kingsbridge is losing more than it earns. We may even run out before we complete the cathedral.
What?
He's right. It won't be finished.
But what about Mother? We wanted to build it for her.
What about going faster?
Could you build faster? Finish it before you run out of money?
Is that an option? Master Builder, you've been awfully quiet so far.
It's hard to say. But yes, Alfred could look at the designs. Could be there's shortcuts that could be taken. I'm not much help yet, but I'll do what I can.
I can do it.
All right. I promise you, I will think about your proposal. Oh, milady, your soup.
Tend to your pottage. It's ready. It only took, like, 3 weeks. It turned out better this time, I think. Sit down with Martha. We used to talk about business, and now everything is about Jack and Alfred. How degrading. We never slept with each other. Alfred gave up a long time ago. When was the last time I sat here? Oh, the construction site. Look, it's going up again. It's growing again. Alfred is working day and night. Hey, you know what? At least he learned that he's not gonna get none. He ain't getting none. Why do I even keep them? When was the last time I took a walk?
Thank you.
Why does she look pregnant?
I'd never thought that my brother could work so hard. He does what he has to. I would never have thought, really. Alfred has changed. He used to be such a bully. He seems really concerned about things now. About Kingsbridge, about you, about your family. I can't wait for you to give me a little nephew or niece.
She's pregnant.
Well, enough about Alfred. Did you get the blue dye I've been asking for? Actually, I did. It's from a woad merchant in Winchester. Took me some time to find him.
Oh, thank you so much, Martha. I guess now I finally have to finish my weaving.
How's it going?
I'm taking my time. I'm not in a rush.
What does Sir Richard think of the idea?
I haven't told him yet. When he comes here, he's mostly interested in coin. But that's the deal. He fights and I pay. It's an endless circle. The coat of arms shall remind us of who we are and where we come from, so we don't end up losing purpose.
Have you decided on an animal yet? You really should have an animal on it.
A lion. Okay. Lion, fox, bear, eagle. So it looks like we're making a coat of arms from the new family she has. So what do you got? What do we want to do? A bear, a lion, a fox, or an eagle? I kind of like the idea of an eagle. Also a bear. Bear sounds really badass. Let's go with a bear.
It will sport a bear.
Oh, bears are scary. I like that. Allie, I'm so sorry that I mentioned wanting a niece. I just thought, in the last month, that you were, well, growing a bit.
Oh, I'm just getting fat. You're not getting fat.
You forget that there's not a lot for me to do other than sit around and eat.
Then we should take a hike soon. Stretch your legs and get some sunshine.
I'd like that. I would like that a lot. But not today. I need to finish the coat of arms first. Get it done while I still can.
Girl, you know this baby's gonna be coming out a redhead. What is going to happen right here? I can't have Jack's baby. I am pregnant. Dude, we're having Jack's baby. Who cares what Alfred thinks? Everyone will think that it's Alfred's baby. Marrying Alfred was a mistake, or I had to marry to fulfill my oath. I just don't want her to try to get rid of the baby. She needs the money to support her brother. Because he's a loser. Nothing he does pleases me, or Alfred is trying his best, actually. He's not a jerk. We don't really care for Alfred, but it could be worse. It could be William. All I do is bicker. I try to be a good wife. I have to keep on going. I don't know what to do anymore. No, she can't fall into a depression pit. She has to keep going. She has to... You know, they made an oath to their father, and I don't think it's the right thing to do, but I don't feel like she should just not get revenge. William needs to go.
I have to keep on going. I had to marry Alfred to fulfill my oath. I wish that Jack would have understood. Love alone could never stop William Hamley. Only money and influence. With Alfred as a husband, I can fulfill my father's last wish. And ever since we've been married, he's been working deep into the nights to finish the cathedral. And when he's home, he expects nothing in return. Although I can see so much longing in his eyes. He is trying his best to make our arrangement work. And I try to be a good wife.
Who is that?
I did what I had to do when I married him. But what I didn't know back then was that... I am pregnant with your grandchild.
You brought this on yourself. You had the love of your life, but you threw it away.
I didn't ask you here to judge me.
Well, pity then that I can't help myself. First and foremost, I blame that priest who turned my son into a monk. But you're a very close second.
How is she gonna get Jack back if she's never leaving the house?
What if I brought Jack back?
Oh, Aliena. Jack has left England. There's no possible way to find out where he went. I want you to know one thing. Jack loved you. For me, that makes you still family. If you can't have his baby, give it to me. I will raise it far away from this crooked world that had no room for my son.
I don't want to give our child away.
Then you cannot stay here. You cannot go on like this.
But I have to. Don't you understand?
I don't want to get rid of the baby.
I want you to wear it when you go to battle. To remind us of what we are fighting for.
Huh. Why a bear?
Because of its strong family bonds. A bear takes care of its kin, and so should we.
You hear that, Alfred? I'm a bear! Roar!
Grow up, Richard. This is important.
Sorry.
How's the war going, by the way?
It can't go on forever, can it?
The good thing is, William Hamley is turning out to be quite the lousy player. In our last battle, he ran away when things started to get a bit tight. They say he was afraid to die before he settled matters with his mother.
His mother?
No one's seen her in years, not since her husband died. But rumor has it she's still alive and joyfully pulling his strings. Mention her to William, and he goes as pale as a sheet. Ali, we are so close, but we need to be careful. We mustn't let our guard down.
Is there anything you need from me, Richard?
Well, a new saddle would be nice.
I'll see to it.
And a horse to put it on, of course.
Oh, Richard's such a dick.
The last one caught quite a few arrows.
Right.
I'll be out for a while. I've got some business at the market with Martha.
All right.
You know what's going to happen is that Alfred's going to start resenting her. He is going to resent that she's not sleeping with him and he's paying all these things for Richard. And Richard is a little dick. and she's also showing that she's pregnant with Jack's baby. This is quite the pickle that she is in now. Elena's coat of arms. Elena's design for a coat of arms serves as an emblem for her family, meant to be worn on a shield, surcoat, tabard, or flag, and carried into battle. Each element on a coat of arms is meant to provide unique insight into the history and ideals of the carrier, which is why Elena chose a bear. They are intimidating and not to be messed with. We never slept with each other. It's finally done. Why did it ever take so long? Now I need to find something new. He's doing well. Who would have thought? And Alfred. Oh, I actually kind of feel bad for Alfred. Let's see. Get some air. Look how angry he looks. Oof. How much I miss having my own business. You know what? I bet at some point we are going to have to decide whether or not to give up the baby to Ellen. And I think that the coat of arms, like being a bear and having, you know, family being important, is going to sway whether or not Eliana keeps the baby. But also that's going to piss off Alfred. It's done. Maybe this will save Kingsbridge. Oh wow, so it's actually done. Let's get out of here, man.
I can't believe you two have almost done it. You've almost won your father's earldom back.
Oh, don't say that until it's actually happened. I'll see you later in the evening.
Ah, there you are.
I always wondered what it would have been like to grow up in a forest.
Oh, it's cold. Very, very cold. When I was young, I spent a night in Ellen's cave. If it hadn't been for her soup, I would have died for sure.
Enjoy the moment. See, it's making us not want to give the baby up to Ellen, or it's going to give us the option to decide. And we have to, as Eliana, find out what it was like for Jack to live out in the woods. It's getting warmer again. Soon the sheep won't need their wool anymore. Time to get back into business. The landing site is for logs and rocks. Maybe we could use it to ship wares too. It would help revive the market. I don't think that that's gonna happen. They say more towns are growing out there. Towns like Kingsbridge. Maybe one day I'll travel again. What else? Martha. That's where Ellen and Jack came from. Can't imagine a life like that. But then, once I couldn't imagine a life like this either. The cathedral. Ever since Alfred talked to Philip, they've been working hard. It's almost finished now. Here she is, cheerful as a bell, as always. Oh, new construction site. Richard urged Alfred to raise a wall to protect us from the Hemleys. But first, we need new coin to build it. All right, Martha.
What kind of soup?
I think it had deer in it.
Deer?
Yes. Jack had caught it before we met him. I think it was the only one he ever caught.
But hunting deer is...
I know. It's punishable by death. Jack never was one for rules and laws.
Right.
So true.
He was always busy with something, just not with what Tom asked him to do.
Jack? Yes. Yes, he was.
You will be an aunt soon.
What?
But don't tell Alfred. I haven't told him yet.
You still think marrying him was a mistake?
I do.
I do too. But you did it for very good reasons. So, maybe it wasn't a mistake after all. Maybe it will work. Not in a loving way, but more like a partnership. You two seeing eye to eye to each other.
Maybe. But the baby is not...
What was that?
Are you kidding me?
They built it too fast. Like the Babylonians, they sought to be grander than God, and for this we all have to suffer.
A stone roof. Alfred tried to build a stone roof without telling Papa.
You're with child. How can you be with child if we never...
My cub is gone and will never return. You threw it all away for a life of lies and a kingdom of dust.
Without a cathedral, my mother will spend an eternity in hell. And by God, I hope you won't suffer the same fate for this. I can't stay. Not without work. And not like this. I'm sorry.
Shh. Shh. There's no need to cry.
Oh, that is so sad. I guess I shouldn't have built the cathedral faster. And plus, Alfred sucked, dude. Oh, this sucks so bad.
There, there. We've been crying for far too long now. Where do we go from here?
Leave Kingsbridge. It's in shambles with no money to rebuild it. It died down. It's been cold for hours. I should really get going. First crown I ever made. I was so proud that day. Well, why don't we take the crown? We don't have anything once again. The house is all mine again. Alfred left Kingsbridge for good. Well, where's Ellen? Oh. It's all gone. There's nothing left for me here.
We will build a cathedral right here, towering high above Shiring. But it will not be a cheap undertaking.
Money is no object. I shall build it for our Lord and my mother, so that the Lord will heal her.
I am sure he will. Ah, yes, there he is.
Who?
We will need a master builder.
My bishop, I think I have the right man.
My bishop, my name is Alfred Builder.
What a douchebag. Chapter 14, Departure. Oh my goodness. This is getting so, is so downing. Like, it's such a downer, dude. Okay, you tried to be kind during the break of a jack. You believe God is unjust. You chose a bear for your coat of arms. You didn't support Alfred's idea to help the workers. In your marriage with Alfred, you struggled not to lose hope. You left Kingsbridge for good, and you finished book two. Wow. Okay, well, what's gonna happen? What's gonna happen when Jack comes back? Where did Ellen go? I don't understand where Philip went. Still have Martha and Tom, and then this backstabber Alfred and Remigius. I felt like Remigius was always on Waylon's side. Man, come on, William can't win this.